Hello, Jim Schwimmer here. Welcome to today's vlog. I really enjoy visiting with everybody. I almost feel like we're old friends talking with each other, even though I'm doing the talking and I can't hear any of you. But I did get a comment from a visitor who said I was trying his patience. Could I please get to the point sooner? I thought about it and I decided that he's right. So I'm going to try to get to the point sooner. If I'm still not, then you could let me know in the comments, and especially the person who made that initial comment, you can let me know how I'm doing. If I'm still taking too long to get to the point, then you could let me know. If I'm doing better, you could let me know that too. But today doesn't count because I wanted to give that explanation that I'm going to try to get to the point. So today doesn't count, but after today, let me know if I'm still not giving everybody what they need when they need it. I don't want to unnecessarily detain anybody. So here we go, right to the point. Today, the Maricopa County Senate, well, I was going to say the Senate, but actually there were only two people there from the Senate. Karen Fan, the president of the Senate, and both Republicans, name of Peterson. I don't remember his first name, but there were two people from the auditors to give just a progress report of what they found. I'm linking to the entire hearing if you want to listen to it. It's about an hour and a half, a little over that. But I'm going to try to, I just took some notes as I was listening and watching. So I'm just going to share some notes with you. But getting to the point, if you're pressed for time, here are their main takeaways. First of all, these cyber ninjas and Cypher, they're the digital forensic experts. Ben Cotton testified for Cypher, and then Doug Logan testified. He is the CEO of the Cyber Ninjas. And finally, Ken Bennett, the liaison between the Senate and the auditors. I want to just give you, first of all, just the important points, which are that it's, well, as I just said, it's in progress. And the reason it's in progress, it's because the Maricopa County election officials are refusing to cooperate. I'm going to mention that a little bit later on in more detail, but that's one of the major bullet points, that they are having trouble. They are not getting any cooperation from the Maricopa County election officials. In fact, Ken Bennett was asked by Karen Fan, what happens when you talk to them, when you ask for information or access to routers or routers, what are the election officials telling you? And they say, talk to our attorney. He contacts the attorney and the attorney says, essentially, we gave you everything we're going to give you. You're not going to get any more. So that leads to the second bullet point. Karen Fan made clear that if they have to, they're going to go to court to get what's being withheld. And I would go now to the next bullet point, which is they are finding serious problems. It looks like whatever Maricopa County did, Peterson was charitable. He said, I'm not saying whether it's deliberate or just incompetence. I have my own conclusion, but I'll just go along with Peterson. But they are finding some serious problems, some serious discrepancies, problems with chain of command, problems with the number of ballots in boxes not matching what the document, the slip that comes with the box says should be in there. And they were all, well, I'll get to that in more detail in a moment. Another takeaway or problem is the ballot paper, the paper on which the ballots are printed, and duplicate ballots. There definitely are duplicate ballots. There are ballots that cannot be traced. I'm going to talk about that in more detail, but those are the main bullet points that I can remember. So if you press for time, that's really it. Now I'm going to go into detail, but there, unless you want this detail, there's no reason to go any farther. So let's see what we got here. Okay, we got a piece of paper. All right, now here we go. Starting with Ben Cotton. Here is his problem. He could not match thousands of duplicated ballots. There were serial, the problem that they were having, number one, these ballots have little black squares that go along the top and the sides of the ballots. The serial numbers, every ballot has to have a serial number printed on it when the ballots come in, but serial numbers are in light gray type. I think he said from a matrix printer, which is pretty primitive. I don't know why they're using those, but the numbers would go across these black squares and would be partially unreadable. And in some cases, there were no serial numbers at all. So that was one problem that they were having. Another problem he pointed out was the poor security of all the machinery, all the computers. He mentioned that if you have a computer, if you have your Windows computer, your Mac computer, or whatever, you have antivirus software, and that software is updated usually every week. And Windows itself will also send up updates. Happens every week, but according to Ben Cotton, there was, the most recent update he was finding was August of 2019. No updates of antivirus programs since August of 2019, making these machines, according to his testimony, very vulnerable. How vulnerable? He was asked specifically, how long would it take somebody to, an evil person, to get past this outdated antivirus protection and just change the machines, change the numbers in the machine, the numbers of votes, et cetera, et cetera. 10 minutes, he said. Within 10 minutes, anybody with, any computer knowledge could get into any evil person, any proficient hacker could get into computers and tabulators to change results, 10 minutes. Now he also talked about, this is one of the things that is being withheld, and this is very important if you've listened this far, something called a Splunk log, which I had never heard of. This is Ben Cotton's explanation and his explanation of the problem and what they need to resolve the issue. But a Splunk log, as I understand it, certain records, I forget which records, data logs, it's actually a record of who logged in to a specific computer. He said that the way these machines work, or these computer works, is they only keep a certain number of records of who accessed that machine or that computer. And what would happen would be if you log in to whatever is being logged into, you can tell I'm not a computer guy. If you log in, you go on a list that goes up and up and up and up, and then when you reach a certain point, I forget what the exact number is, but yeah, I don't have it here. You get to a certain point, and then when somebody logs in after that, then the source, the person who logged in, who's at the bottom of the list, that gets deleted. And as new people log in, then people at the bottom get deleted. What happens is you lose the earlier records unless you can do a forensic analysis. You need certain information that's not being provided. So what he found was there should be, what they need is the records going back to election day, or even the day before the election, November 2nd or November 3rd, but they only have records going back to February 8th, long after the election. So anything that happened, anybody that logged in before February 8th, 2021, they don't know. And what they do know, what he found, was that at one point, 37,000 people logged in, or there were 37,000 login requests or 37,000 logins. And what that did was push the bottom name down, or bottom IP address, whatever it was, pushed it down 37,000 lines way before, well, February 8th, 2021. So that is a major problem that he pointed out. But he also, either it was he or Peterson asked, it was a kind of a rhetorical question, didn't have the answer, but Maricopa County, the officials said, and not just this, but all these problems I'm going to mention, they claim that they did a complete audit, that they found no problems. So the obvious question is, if this was such a complete audit, why did that audit, or those audits, because Maricopa County said that they did it twice, how did these audits, these supposedly terrific audits, miss 37,000 queries? Oh, that's what it was, queries, 37,000 queries. And in fact, all these other problems that I'm going to mention that the Cyber Ninjas and Cypher found. How did they miss it? Either they missed it, or they're lying, or they found it and they're covering up. So that's personally my opinion, because as I've said in the past, you're going to get to it right now, because now I'm moving on to Doug Logan, the CEO of the Cyber Ninjas. And he said, this is something I said earlier, I called it the tone at the top, that if you're doing an audit, say a financial audit, because I used to work for the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants, working on their self-study courses, so I have some knowledge of this, even though I'm not an accountant. This term, the tone at the top, you're going to do an audit, and if you go in and the CEO is very open, very frank, lets you look at whatever you want, answers any questions that you have, shows you anything that you want to see, then you know you're going to have an easy audit. If you get resistance, then you know you're going to have, number one, a difficult audit, and you also know, number two, or you have reason to suspect that there's some chicanery going on, that there's some shenanigans, something wrong. Otherwise, why are they resisting? That's what Doug Logan said. He said in every previous audit that he has done, people were always available to answer his questions, and he was always able to see whatever he needed to. But this time, for the first time in all the audits he's done, he's getting incredible resistance. The people just don't want to, the election officials, Maricopa County, they don't want to turn over certain information. Now, I have to talk about something called alignment bleed through, and I'm putting up a little exhibit. This is a screenshot of an exhibit that they put on the screen there. You can see that there is a kind of a target type of, there's a circle and then there's a little target cross, like a gun sight. That cross is supposed to be firmly or well within that circle, centered in that circle. As you can see, the normal one at the top and the one at the bottom, you can see the one at the bottom, that there is a serious alignment problem. And he said that that can cause a vote not to be counted. It could cause a double vote. It could cause a ballot to be audited for a different candidate than the one for whom the person filling out the ballot wanted to vote. He also mentioned something called bleed through. Maricopa County says that they use special paper, and there is a special paper. It has a special coating on it, and it has a certain thickness such that Maricopa County said they use four different types of paper. They named the sources of the paper, and Doug Logan's obvious conclusion is that this paper that these were printed on, it's thinner paper. So either there was something wrong with the official paper, which they should easily be able to track down the auditors by going to the four manufacturers or the sources of that paper, or somebody was using unofficial paper. And then the question is, how did that happen? And here's the quote, actually, exact quote from Logan. quote, a lot of very thin paper stuck, unquote. So that is a question, all these questions that have to be answered. Now, here's something else that Logan found. There is most of the ballots that were cast in Maricopa County, they were mail-in ballots. He found over 74,000, I believe the figure was 74,340 ballots with no clear record of ever being sent. In other words, they got back, or Maricopa County received more ballots than there is a record of having been sent out. That raises an obvious question. If you sent out a certain amount of ballots and then you get more ballots back than you sent out, well, you have to wonder about those extra ballots. What else did he find here? 11,326 people who voted were not on the voter roll as of November 2nd. They were added to the voter roll later. When? December 4th. 11,326 people were not on the rolls, and then somehow magically they were on the rolls as of December 4th. So one has to wonder how that happened. That's how they phrased everything. They didn't accuse anybody of anything. They just said, how could this have happened? We need more information to resolve the issue. That is the problem, that they are getting no cooperation from Maricopa County to resolve all these questions that I'm sharing with you today. And I think it's obvious. Well, to me, it's only my opinion. I could be wrong, but it's my opinion, because they know something is wrong and they don't want to admit it. They're hiding something. Next item, to vote in the November 3rd election, a voter had to be registered by October 15th. But there were 3,928 voters shown as having voted, but they were registered after the deadline. Next item from Logan, 18,000 voters who were on the voter rolls when they voted, but were later removed after the election. So before the election, they were on the rolls. After the election, they were not on the rolls. One wonders how that happened, why that happened. Again, Maricopa County doesn't want to cooperate and help to answer these questions. Next item, envelopes. Every mailed-in ballot, every absentee ballot mailed in should have a corresponding envelope. Now, of course, once you separate the envelopes from the ballots, you can no longer match a specific envelope with a specific ballot, but the total number of mail-in ballots and envelopes should match. It's a simple matter of counting the ballots and then counting the envelopes. It's really that simple. The auditors asked for images of the envelopes, or they asked for images of the envelopes, which Maricopa County is supposed to have. They sent them a computer file. They said that the envelopes, the images of the envelopes, they were on this computer file, but they weren't. Obviously, Ben Cotton, an experienced expert digital auditor, if those envelopes are in that file, certainly he would find them, but he couldn't find them, Logan couldn't find them, and their response every time the auditors said to Maricopa County, we can't find these envelope images on this file, something is wrong, we can't find them, the only response they've been getting is, they're on there, they're on the file, that's their only response. Again, not cooperating. And I would just mention really briefly, the routers, Maricopa County is saying that they can't turn over the routers because the routers contain sensitive information. Ben Cotton said that is nonsense. He likened it to if you mail a letter. If I mail a letter to you, I write my letter, I put it in the envelope, and then the postman delivers the envelope to you, and then you take out the letter. But he doesn't open the envelope and see what's inside. He merely is the means of transmitting the letter, and that is all that these routers do. They just transmit information from one point to another, and the only thing that should be on the routers and the only thing that should be on those routers, the only thing also in which the auditors are interested, is to know what went through those routers. Where did it come from? Where did it go? And was there any point at which the routers were connected to the internet? That's all they want to know, and that is all that should be on the routers. Again, Maricopa County is not cooperating. Those are the major points, the major issues, the major things found so far in this incomplete audit that was revealed today at the hearing. At the end of the hearing, Logan was asked, I think it was by Peterson, but I'm not sure, but one of the two, Peterson or Fan, asked him to just recite a list of all the things that they need from Maricopa County to do a complete forensic audit. And he took quite a long time. I'm not going to give you the list now. Again, I linked to the hearing. You can watch the whole thing. But he gave a very, very, very long list. And it wasn't even a detailed list, just a very long list of things that he needs, that the auditors need, that Maricopa County is refusing to provide. Which brings us to the end of the hearing. Karen Fan, well, Peterson made a statement, and then Karen Fan said, we're going to have to go to court. That's what she said. So we must have this information. Or she said, if we have to go to court, we will, and it looks like we're going to have to go to court. That's really it. That's where the Maricopa County audit is right now. If I have further updates, of course, I'll share them with everybody. And again, I recommend everybody, if you have time, watch the entire hearing. It was very illuminating. And then if you could also give me a thumbs up, that would really be great. If you like this video, share with anybody you think would also like it. Got any comments? Comment section below the video. Or you can put questions, suggestions for future topics. You could subscribe. I love getting new subscribers. You could visit my other channels, my hot dog recipe channel, my original music channel, links in the description. But most of all, I appreciate the time you spent with me. I gave you a summary up at the front, but as you can see, there was a lot that happened in this hearing. I'm pretty sure I just gave you only substantive information, no personal anecdotes this time, but it took more time than I thought it would, but as I said, there was a lot, and I thought it was important. And I hope those of you who stuck with me will come back and see me again. And I will try to get to the point really quick and hopefully be brief. Yesterday's was only about, 5 minutes, the whole video, maybe only about 3.5. So that's it. Thanks for stopping by. I look forward to seeing all of you again. And until I do see all of you again, bye.